When things move, they create waves. For example, if you shake a stick back and forth in water, you get water waves. Vibrate a piece of metal back and forth really fast, and you get air pressure waves. Shake some electrons back and forth really fast, and you get radio waves. And yes, shake a planet or star back and forth really fast, and you get gravitational waves. Gravitational waves happen because the effects of gravity don't travel outwards at infinite speed. So if the sun were to suddenly jump a few 100,000 kilometers to one side, the changed gravitational field would take time to pulse outwards. And if the sun shook back and forth and back and forth instead of a single pulse, you'd get continuous gravitational waves. So what's doing the waving? In the case of water, the height of the water increases and decreases at any particular location as the waves travel past. In the case of sound, the pressure of the air increases and decreases at any particular location as the waves travel past. In the case of radio or cell phone signals or any other electromagnetic waves, the electric and magnetic fields get stronger and weaker at any particular location as the waves travel past. And in the case of gravitational waves, the gravitational field gets slightly stronger or weaker as the waves travel past. You can tell a wave has passed by looking at how nearby particles behave. A bobber on the water rises up and down. The electrons in a radio antenna move back and forth because of the changing electric field. And free-floating people or planets or cats move back and forth because of the changing gravitational field. Though in this last case, the peculiarities of gravity mean that the free-floating things actually experiencing the gravitational wave don't feel like they're moving. But if you measure the space between them by sending a pulse of laser light and measuring the time it takes for it to come back, you'll find that the distance between them increases and decreases. In practice, physicists don't actually measure gravitational waves with free-floating cats. They use very, very fancy, expensive mirrors, which are effectively free-floating in one direction because they're hung on pendulums suspended on isolation tables suspended on isolation tables, or which are actually free-floating because they're attached to satellites floating in space, though this hasn't been done yet. The reason physicists need fancy floating mirrors to detect gravitational waves is that the waves are very, very weak. For example, the electrons that vibrate back and forth in a radio antenna to make electromagnetic waves also make gravitational waves. Electrons are matter moving back and forth, after all. But the waves they make are super weak. A 200-watt radio transmitter gives off something like a quadrillionth of a quintillionth of a quintillionth of a quintillionth of that amount of power as gravitational radiation. And that's why here on Earth, we can only detect the biggest, baddest astronomical events, like superfast spinning neutron stars or merging black holes or the Big Bang, though so far we've only detected black hole collisions. If you'd like to help in the search for gravitational waves, there's a project called Einstein at Home, which allows physicists to send calculations to your computer when you're not using it and help directly in the search for superfast spinning neutron stars. All you out there who have computers that are sitting idle overnight, maybe even super fancy gaming computers with high-end GPUs and CPUs, or just a regular computer, if you're not using it overnight and you want to leave it on and help support science, they make it really easy for you to get this up and running. You just download it, install it, sign in, set up when you want your computer to be available for calculations, and that's about it. I have mine set up to run overnight if I'm not using my computer. You just need to go to einsteinathome.org to download the software and get started. Maybe your computer will help detect the first gravitational waves from a spinning neutron star.